Welcome to the Dynamics Byte. Today we are going to talk about how system administrators can set up and configure the Supplier Communications Agent. So we have distributed whole end-to-end setup process in 7 steps. Let's understand details against these steps and see in action how it can be configured. Enabling agents in finance and operation with Immersive Home. Immersive Home introduces a modern AI-powered experience as the new default start page in finance and operations, designed to support agents and Copilot functionality. Users can activate it through features management, but it is important to note that if an admin disables the feature, all personalized start page settings will revert. To fully enable agent capabilities, organizations must ensure that finance and operation environment is connected to a Dataverse environment and that all necessary Copilot features are enabled within the Power Platform. This setup lays the foundation of a more intelligent and efficient user experience, driving the shift towards AI-enabled operation. Prerequisites for enabling Supplier Communication Agent. To fully enable agent-driven capabilities in Microsoft Dynamics 365 Supply Chain Management, it is essential to be running version 10.044 or later. And if you are on version 10.044 specifically, make sure to install the latest quality update to ensure all integration components are up to date. Additionally, several features must be activated through feature management, namely Immersive Home, Agent Management, and the Supplier Communication Agent, all marked as production ready preview. On the Power Platform side, it is also crucial to have the correct supporting packages installed. Copilot for finance and operation apps and Copilot in Microsoft Dynamics 365 Supply Chain Management. Make sure to take the latest package installed. Meeting these prerequisites ensures a seamless and fully functional Copilot experience in your supply chain environment. Enabling Copilot and billing. To ensure Copilot works correctly in your Dynamics 365 environment, you need to verify that it is enabled in the Power Platform Admin Center. Confirm that messaging billing is active and make sure the required capacity has been purchased and assigned to the environment linked to finance and operation. So usually we will be seeing 3 types of users, and first one is agent identity user. It enables the Supplier Communication Agent to interact with Dataverse, Microsoft Copilot Studio, and Dynamics 365 Supply Chain Management. In nutshell, setting up the Supplier Communication Agent starts with creating a dedicated agent identity that will securely interact with both Dataverse and Microsoft Copilot Studio. For best security and easier maintenance, it is recommended to use a separate dedicated identity. Assign specific security roles in both Dataverse and Dynamics 365 Supply Chain Management. In Dataverse, these includes Finance and Operation Basic User, Supply Communication Agent, and Environment Maker. In Dynamics 365 Supply Chain Management, the roles needed are System User and Preview Supplier Communication Agent. Assigning these roles ensures the agent has the right permission to function correctly across platform. To ensure users can effectively interact with the Supplier Communication Agent, all Dynamics 365 Supply Chain Management user involved must also be set up as users in Dataverse if they haven't been already. Once users' accounts are in place, it is critical to assign the appropriate security role based on their level of interaction with the agent. Now let's talk about other 2 users. Users managing agent configuration. Users will be configuring and managing the agent requires higher level permission, including roles like basic users, finance and operation agent configuration manager, and finance and operation basic users in Dataverse, and system users, purchasing manager or purchasing agent in Microsoft Dynamics Supply Chain Management. Users reviewing agents' results. For users who are only reviewing the outcomes generated by the agents, a more limited set of roles, such as basic users, finance and operation basic users for Dataverse, and for system users and purchasing agent for Microsoft Dynamics 365 Supply Chain Management user roles. To fully enable the Supplier Communication Agent, it's important to set up the necessary connection and activate the triggering flow. This process begins in the Power App Maker portal, where you need to be signed in as an environment administrator. First, create a new connection for Microsoft Dataverse, making sure to authenticate using the dedicated agent identity. Then repeat the process to create a connection for Microsoft Copilot Studio Preview, again signing in with the same agent identity. Once both connections are created, they will appear in your connection list under the agent's name. So for this final steps, use the application production ready preview, set up supplier communication agent, and this will update agent's connection references and activate triggering flows. To enable email analysis and delivery features of the supplier communication agent, you must set up the targeted mailbox to be synchronized with Microsoft Dataverse at the server level. This can be performed with either private or shared mailbox. In case of private mailbox, mailbox owner must update personalization settings to track all emails. And in case of shared mailbox, create a queue in Power Platform Admin Center and provide access to all users that are using the incoming email workspace to read email content belonging to the shared mailbox. Let's see all these explanations in action. I'm handing it over to Christian. Over to you, Christian.
Excellent. Let's go and enable this supplier communication agent in a real environment. The first thing we want to do is enable the immersive home. Let's go to feature management and identify this feature. The immersive home is the key experience from the adaptive experiences and is always available independent of agents. So when users enter the dashboard, they will be invited to enable the immersive home. And by deciding to try it out, the immersive home will be set as their new default start page, which can be seen in the personalization settings. All right, so if users want to revert that, those are options, they can do that. The preferences, here's the immersive home as their start page. If an admin disables that feature, all these immersive home settings as the start page will be reverted from all users who have set it. What we see here is not yet any agents enabled. The next step on our journey to enable agent is to enable the agent management in feature management. But before we can do that, we need to fulfill a number of prerequisites. Let's take a look at those needed prerequisites. The first step is to assure that the Dataverse environment has been associated to our finance and operations environment. We can do that in LCS. Here we see when navigating to our project and then to our F&O environment details, we see that a Power Platform integration has been set up. We don't need to set up the dual write application for that. If you see here an activity that is needed to enable that that integration, please execute that environment. As well, it is recommended to install the latest quality updates in order to make sure we have the latest bits for the integration in place. Agent integration, agent management might not be available if the version is not on a required latest version. In the next step, we will look at the Dataverse environment associated to finance and operations. Here in the Power Platform Admin Center, I can identify the environment and open that environment. The first thing we want to do is to assure that Copilot has been enabled in our environment. We're looking at product features, and all the way at the top is already the Copilot feature. We want to make sure it's enabled. It is by default, so Copilots and agents can be utilized in our environment. The next step we need to check is if billing has been enabled for Copilot messaging. Here in the Platform Admin Center, we look at licensing and select Copilot Studio. It is important to see that a capacity is available, has been purchased and assigned to our environment. If that is not the case in your environment, you need to go into Manage Billing Plans, add a billing plan, and then associate amounts of acquired capacity to the environment associated to finance and operations. The final step is to check that we have the latest Copilot and agent packages in our environment. So let's go to, again to our Dataverse environment, and this time we go to Dynamics 365 apps. What we want to check is that Dynamics Copilot or Copilot for Finance Operation apps, Copilot and Microsoft Dynamics Finance and Supply Chain Management are installed and no updates are available here. Here you see my latest version as of today. Install any updates needed. If the application is not available, you can install that application into your environment as well. Back in Finance Operation, we go now to Feature Management in order to enable Agent Management. So let's find our agent features. Agent Management is the first feature that needs to be enabled before we can enable any other agents. Agent Management, it's possible now to enable this. While at it, we as well can enable the Supplier Communication Agent and the Account Reconciliation Agent. And the Send Follow-Up Emails to Vendor Agent we can enable as well. Once back on the Immersive Home and the Refresh, we will see invitations to use some of the agents that we have enabled. But before we can use these agents for real, we have to take a few other steps. Let's go to those. In order to give the agent an identity, I've created a user in the tenant. That user is called SCM agent here in my case. And I have assigned a Dynamics 365 Supply Chain Management license. Here in that. If you don't have a supply chain management license available, instead, you can also assign a Power Automate Premium license to the agent identity user. In the environment settings, I have added this user to our environment and then given it the required security roles. For the finance reconciliation agent, we have that specific role, account reconciliation agent. But we also needed to give it the environment maker role and the finance and operations basic user. And for supply chain agent, we have the supplier communication agent role. And finally, I went to finance and operations and opened the users page. I've imported this user into finance and operations. And then here in finance and operations, I have assigned it as well, the roles supplier communication agent in finance operations and the account reconciliation agent. With those settings, we are ready to enable our agents with those identities. Now I need to create two connections in the maker experience for Power Apps. I select the environment, and then I identify the connections button and create two connections. I have done that already. How do I do that? I click on New Connection. I look for Dataverse and Copilot Studio later on as well. And then I select this connection type. I create a new connection and then select the user and that is going to work with this connection, SCM agent user. I'm going to sign in with that user and I'm doing that for both Dataverse and Copilot Studio. Now you have to connect those connections that we just have created to the flows and the agents that we're using. Supply Chain Management has provided a convenient app that we can use. We can open the app here from the application picker. We scroll down and identify the production ready preview, set up Supplier Communication Agents app. And we pick the app for the respective environment which we are using. The app starts up and we see here that three flows are marked as draft. They're not activated yet. In order to activate them, we are selecting the connector for the Dataverse. Here for the supplier agent, that was the user account, the agent identity I had been using. And we're doing the same thing for the Copilot Studio. That connection, we pick that one here. And now all we do is we click apply. And now what's happening is that these connections will be configured, or these flows will be configured to those connections, and they will be activated. And back in finance on the immersive home, we see now three agents. One is the supplier communication agent that helps us to receive emails from suppliers and applying the changes that might arrive to the purchase orders. In order to utilize that, we need a mailbox for the procurement department. Let's take a quick look how we create that. We start at the Microsoft 365 Admin Center and go to Exchange. In Exchange on the mailboxes, we create a new shared mailbox or a procurement mailbox. In order to use the mailbox for our procurement team, we go back to the Power Platform Admin Center to our environment and look for Teams. In the Teams tab, I have already created the procurement team. Let's open that. The procurement team essentially has a few members here, but in order to assign it a queue, we can do that here. A queue will help us to connect that team to a shared mailbox. So let's add a new queue here. And let's call this our procurement queue if we want. And we're going to use our procurement mailbox email that we have created. And when we save it, it will create a mailbox entry in Dynamics. We can take a look at that. On this email, it has the email address that we have defined in Exchange, and we can approve that email. And now we can test and enable the mailbox. This is scheduling a test run, and soon we will hopefully see that this mailbox is fully enabled. We are also setting the owner of the procurement queue, as well the owner of the mailbox, both to the procurement team. Our procurement team and the shared mailbox is now fully set up to be used in the supplier communication agent. Now we are able to activate the supplier communication agent. Let's press try it out. This is the rule that the agent follows. When any vendor sends an email about a purchase order to, and we select our mailbox procurement, then show me a summary of the changes. So let's activate this agent. In case you experience an error that happens when you activate the agents, then you should navigate to Power Apps, Solutions, identify the Copilot for Finance and Operations apps, open that, look at the cloud flows, select each of the cloud flow and see if the status is on or off. If it's off, turn it on. But now we are back on the immersive home and see that this agent purchase order updates from vendor has been enabled. We can navigate to its page and see what it's doing for us. And it didn't take long, and the first supplier sent us an email about a change. And the Copilot, the agent, has identified which order it was for and has identified change it. It has confirmed the order and has identified there is a change in quantity. The user can review the email, can review the changes, and apply all suggested changes with one click. Thank you.